In the studios, I have a licensed coach and education expert, and she has two sons who have been described as geniuses in the UK, and that's a big, big deal. She's more focused on helping parents know the right way to guide their children so they can be successful. She says she is interested in raising leaders, and so there's so much to talk about. Elaine Cunningham Walker, welcome.
Thank you.
Bibi Aboko.
Oh, yes.
Ah.
Oh, aye. Sorry.
No, don't worry.
My papa ye in Crany. My mommy ye fancy. No, Fiona, you're fine.
Uh-huh. Well, because I know Kemi Akeshi.
Oh.
Why ye gamo?
Why ye
anyway, gam. Good to have you in the studios.
Yep.
And you are big on education.
I am very big on education.
Why is that?
Nelson Mandela said, to change a nation, you need to educate a child. And I just feel that with education, it just gives you more opportunities.
Mm.
It opens up certain things. It puts you in front of certain people.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I tend to quote the Bible as Proverbs, right? And the Bible says that your gift will make room for you.
Mm-hmm.
And so a lot of children, every child that comes into this world comes with a gift.
Yeah.
And our job as parents is to nurture that gift. Yes, education, we have academia.
Yes.
But there's another way to educate a child
exactly.
as well. Yeah.
Because I was going to say that not every child is bright in school.
No.
When I was in school, there were people who weren't doing too well, but now they're fine. I mean, when we talk about Richard Branson, he had dyslexia.
He did.
And his headmaster told him that you're either going to end up in jail.
Yeah.
And all of that. And so you look at such people who are doing so well now and you wonder, so is academic, is the academia the most important thing when it comes to the brilliance of a child?
Not at all. I mean, when we talk about Richard Branson, for example, mm-hmm. he had dyslexia. He was in a private boarding school that supported his dyslexia.
Mm.
So although maybe he couldn't get ideas down on paper, he was a bag full of ideas.
Mm.
And it was just a case of putting it down. So now with dyslexia, we have computers that help children. I know a young man that I was working with who had dyslexia who got 12 A stars at GCSEs and 4 A stars. He's now reading engineering at Durham. So he's a smart
But that's
boy.
Because he found himself in the right environment.
He found himself in the right environment. He had a mum that was his advocate. You know, she was gunning for him all the way. And she made sure that he was in the school that supported him. And that school in particular has got lots of children who, and I don't like to call them learning difficulties.
Okay.
I like to call them challenges.
Mm.
Because they overcame their challenges to become simply amazing. It's one of the best schools in the UK. But like you write, like you said, my children are gifted musically.
Mm-hmm.
So between the two of them, they play 7 instruments.
Yeah.
So you can be, that's a form of being a genius. Einstein was thought of being, he had autism.
Yeah.
But he was, a lot of the things that we look at now, E equals MC squared.
Yeah, that's all from him.
It's all from him, exactly. And at school, he was deemed a nuisance.
Yeah.
Someone like there's a footballer, I think, I don't follow football.
No, it's but, fine. I don't either. So
I think it's called Ronaldo.
Okay.
And Ronaldo was, and he's a sportsman, right? So that's his specialty.
Mm-hmm.
But when he was at school, he was deemed as a nuisance because he used to kick things. But one teacher looked at him and said, "You kick things a lot. Just get you outside." And that was the beginning of Ronaldo.
Yeah.
You know, so sometimes we see things like, especially in our community, we might see a child that talks a lot.
Yeah. And they'll tell you, "Oh, kasadodo yedin. You talk too much."
Yeah. But that could be a politician in the making.
Mm.
That could be a diplomat in the making. The way that they speak, I was always told that I was chatterbox at school.
Mm.
But my speaking and my soft skills and my relationship skills has got me to where I am right now.
Yeah.
You know, so yeah.
So then the parents have to discover these things and channel all their energy
they
to ensuring.
They do. And I think it's really important to nurture gifts that we see in our children.
Okay.
Sometimes it's a bit challenging. And I think we have to put children in environments. So here I'm not so sure, but I know that in the UK there are extracurricular activities. So
mm-hmm. there are some here as well.
There are some here as well. So if you've got a child that talks a lot, put them in debating club.
Okay.
They need to learn to debate. And if you've got a child that's constantly kicking, football club, rugby club, something that's sporty. I always say boys are like dogs.
Mm.
So you have to feed them and make sure they run around and burn off their energy. Girls can be very creative, you know. I know we're trying to change that by getting more girls into STEM subjects.
Into STEM, yeah.
I'm a scientist by background, so I love science.
Mm.
However, science is used in cooking.
Yeah.
Home economics, people don't realize that. And I was telling somebody the other day, because they asked me at Christmas, how did I make my roast potatoes so fluffy?
Mm-hmm.
And I said, well, I just used a theory from physics. And he was just like,
You use physics to make your meals?
Physics to make my meals.
Okay.
Conventional air.
Okay.
You know, but it's physics. Home economics is physics. You know, but because we don't label it like that, we think that it's not a science, part of science.
But is that not putting too much pressure on your child? You want your child to become a genius. And I'm asking this because your children took part in Child Genius in the UK. Mm-hmm. And after the competition, everybody said, or majority of people said, you're putting too much pressure on the kids. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. They're too young. Let them live like kids. Yeah. And when they're ready to grow up, they will.
Okay.
And so some parents have tried to push their kids into some competitions and some spaces. Mm-hmm. And everybody looks at them and says, but they're too young. They're just kids. Let them be kids.
Yeah, they're kids, and I think but what we also have to realize is that our responsibility as parents is to look at those children. Mm-hmm. We're growing children to become adults, and there are certain disciplines that we need to help them with. So for example, yes, let them be kids, so we let them enjoy what they're doing, so they don't realize that they are actively becoming a better speaker, a better leader. They're able to fail in a safe place.
Okay.
Where my household is very open, so people might look at us and go, you don't respect your mum. But that's not actually true. But what I actually try and create in my household is an environment where they can say anything with no retributions. Mm-hmm. Within reason.
Okay.
Within reason. Uh-huh. Okay. But they can't insult me, of course. But then they can talk about their feelings, how they feel. And I'm very open with my feelings as well. But that took time, because I was never that kind of parent before.
Yeah.
I was always that kind of parent who was... you know, I'm the parent, you're the child,
so
blah, blah, blah.
Let's know our places.
Yes, let's know our places. But I think after I got to a point when I got divorced, when the children were quite young, I realised that I wanted to become a more effective parent, and I wanted my children to be able to talk to me about absolutely anything.
Mm.
And that's when I changed the way I parent.
Okay.
So I created an environment that really managed their self-esteem, mm-hmm. their expectations in mm-hmm. life, their confidence. Once you get those things right and made discipline positive rather than punitive, once I got all of that, the attainment came by itself. They were able to tell me, Mummy, I want to enjoy this. I mean, I remember when my son came to me and said to me, Mummy, I want to learn the bassoon. I was thinking to myself, who's going to carry that?
Mm.
You know, bassoon. And I said, well, you know, where did you hear that? He said, oh, I was watching YouTube, blah, blah, blah. I said, okay, let's see how it goes. And I think as parents, we get so stuck in, well, you're going to be a doctor and you have
and
to
you
study
have
this.
To be, yeah.
But I've got lots of friends who've become doctors who did history,
mm-hmm.
Who did so many other things, or they completed a different life. They were a lawyer and then they decided, actually, I want to do medicine.
Yeah.
You know, so it is about discovering who you are.
That's important.
Yeah.
And there's an interview on Forbes Africa. Well, I'm not sure if it's Forbes. It's Forbes.com.
Yeah.
You should check it out on 10 tips by which parents can help their children become geniuses. That must have been a big deal as well.
That was a big deal. But I don't believe that we help children become geniuses. I believe that everybody's born with genius.
Okay.
That's our motto in our company. I believe that every child is born with genius, just needs to be nurtured. Mm. Yeah.
But you're in Ghana now. It's all about the British Boarding School Expo. Tell me about that.
So we have lots of connections with some of the best boarding schools in the UK.
Okay.
And they obviously want to enrich their community, enrich their schools with students from Ghana. Because they know from my kids that students from Ghana are exceptionally bright, and they're offering various scholarships
mm-hmm.
for children to come over to the UK, whether you were born in the UK, whether you were born in America, whether you were born in Ghana. We have a legal team that helps you with all that documentation to come over and enrich their school community.
Okay.
So they are coming tonight, actually.
All right.
And we're starting this program. So they are going around with me. I think we have about 15 schools this time. When we came in February, we had 23.
Okay.
But our February event tends to be the bigger one.
Mm.
But they're coming to enjoy Ghana.
Okay, and of course, to help other parents also know the importance.
Exactly.
Of
so we have we have an event where parents can talk to the schools and address some of the concerns that they might have about sending your child, because it's a big deal. It's a big decision. I think boarding school, whether you're in country or out of country, is always a big deal.
It's
always a concern.
Yeah. We'll have time to discuss this maybe later on, because some parents don't think that boarding is the right thing for their children, especially when they're very young.
Yeah.
But when is this starting?
This is starting on Friday at Stanbic Bank, Stanbic Heights.
Okay.
From 6 till 8.
Okay.
And then on Saturday, so 6 till 8, we have the networking events, which we call Meet the Heads.
Okay.
And then Saturday, we have the expo, which starts from 10 till 6.
Mm.
And Sunday, we start from 12, because we know that Ghanaians like church. So yeah. We go to church first.
So after church.
And a little bit of brunch, and then come. Yeah.
So and if they want there. More information, they can want, reach you?
They can reach me. I'll be there.
Okay.
They can also reach me on my LinkedIn, Facebook, Instagram, everything.
Well, yeah. So just type in Elaine Cunningham Walker on LinkedIn, and it'll take you to a page, and you can contact her directly. Thank you so much
Thank
for joining
you.
Me on air. And
Thank
we have a lot to discuss off air as well.
Thank you.